y'all, man. This is another fire episode of Mirror Check. We coming back with a special episode. And you know, I cannot do this without my partner. What's up, man? What's good, Willie? What's up, man?
What's happening, my boy? What's going on, man? What's happening? How you feeling, man?
You know me. I'm blessed by the best, man. How you doing?
Man, I'm great, man. I'm great. Yes, always sir. Great. I'm always trying to be in an upbeat and uplifting spirit, man.
Already.
Man, yeah, coming on here, man, and breaking bread with the listeners.
Oh, yeah.
And our followers, man. We appreciate y'all, man.
We do. We do. We really do. We appreciate the feedback, too. We really do. Man, so... Let's bring the cat out the bag, you know, or the hat, whatever they say.
Or the elephant in the room, like
yeah. Let's ruffle some feathers real quick. Man, this episode, man, I'm gonna just be straight up with you guys. Ladies, we really do appreciate you guys, or you ladies, sorry. This is an episode that you should just sit back and just listen. I mean, you can comment and everything, but just sit back and listen. Yeah, it'll open up your eyes and give you an understanding of why certain things are the way they are. So yeah, let me just tell y'all a little bit about this episode. Fellas, you know, you might judge us for opening up this topic, but it's something that needs to be discussed. Not disgusted. Disgust.
Disgust.
And yeah, you might be disgusted, but yeah, it needs to be explained. It needs to be brought to the forefront. So this topic today is, what are men afraid to admit to women?
Yeah, that's a deep one.
What are men afraid to admit to women?
Ooh,
I already know, y'all. Ooh, they afraid to admit this. Okay, y'all can comment. You know, we appreciate your comments. But just listen. Fellas, you can comment, because that's going to, you know, allow women to really understand, you know, the different men, how they was raised and their thought process and everything
right.
like that.
Right.
So, yeah, men comment, women listen, and then after the show, comment. I'm just messing y'all. Y'all comment how y'all want to, you know what I'm saying? But I really truly believe that y'all should just listen for a moment, because this is going to get real deep, man. So, I mean, what do you think? What do you think men are afraid to admit to women? What do you think?
I think it's a lot of different things, but I think the one thing that I probably hit on a lot of different, you know, angles. I'm pretty sure you will too, to kind of give them different angles on what we think.
Okay.
But I think one of the main things that men wrestle with and fear of is the ability of their worth being tied to them being their provider.
Gotcha. Yeah.
You know, most of the time, you know, when we're in relationships, whether it's boyfriend, girlfriend, husband and wife, and you feel like as a man that you're not provided in the way that you're supposed to provide.
Right. Yeah.
You simply suppress those feelings, you suppress those thoughts, you suppress those emotions.
Right.
You
right.
find a way to try to get the bag, you find a way to try to get this done, get that done without your significant other or your spouse,
yeah.
you know, seeing your emotion and trusting that you're going to get it done,
yeah,
you know,
yeah,
one way or another. And so I think that's one of the biggest things that men wrestle with or we fear and hide the most is the fact that our worth is tied to us being a provider. Like I shared with you earlier before we got on here, like I have a coworker, you know, I ain't mention her name, but I have a coworker, you know, we're always chopping it up, just talking about different, you know, relational topics and stuff like that. And she was like, my dude, you know, came to me personally. It was like, you're really with a man, you know, that that's broke. That's basically what he said.
He was honest.
At least he was honest and transparent. So you're
yeah, talk.
And she was like, so ladies, listening to this response is not the response that I was expecting to get, you know, from a woman. Yeah. And so as we're talking, she was like, well, my response to him was, I'm not just in this relationship for money. I'm not just in a relationship for monetary value. I want to be in this relationship in order to help build you up, in order to, that's a real woman, man. Real that's a real woman. To build you up, to help you grow, to help you thrive, to help you flourish and build this thing together.
Yeah.
Because most of the time when we see, you know, in social media or relationships, you know, when women are in that position, or people we may know personally, when they feel like they man ain't doing what they supposed to do or provide, or man. Might find himself in a hard place, and he shares that with his woman, and he feel like he's belittled.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? And not feeling appreciated, and his woman not, you know, uplifting him rather than bringing him down.
Right.
And
right,
so
right,
that
right.
was that response that, you know, my coworker gave me kind of blew me away as a woman.
Man.
Like, I'm here to help build you up. We'll work on finances together. We'll work on financial strategies and whatever we got to do, sit down with an advisor and budgeting. We'll work all of that right. together through along their process and their relationship. And so, you know, that really, really blew me away as a woman, you know, sharing her thoughts on that, man. Yeah, so. Yeah. It was deep, but I think that's one thing, though.
So why do you think men think that way? Like, when you was referring back to, like, why men do what they do? Like, is it because of pride? Why, I mean, why? Does that play a role in why men do what they do or what?
Absolutely. I do believe
not
pride.
Depending on their significant other, just basically say, I'm going to go get it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I really do believe pride is definitely one of the major keys of why us men don't share what we share. You know, we've been taught, we've been wired that way to go out there and get it by any means necessary. Not showing any emotion, coming to the house, you know, laughing and joking like everything is all good, but deep down inside, we trying to figure it out.
Man, we dying.
We dying on the inside, man. We trying to figure out a way to get it done. And so I think, you know, pride is definitely one of the biggest things, not really showing that emotion and bottling that in. And it's funny you say that, because the same coworker that I had to talk with was the same coworker that asked me that question, like, why do men have so much pride?
Yeah, yeah.
She
yeah.
asked me that same question. I was like, most of us were just wired that way.
Right, right.
We're taught to go out here and get it by any means necessary.
Specifically in the black community.
Yeah.
For real, like.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, you know, some people were spoon-fed, you know what I'm saying? And in the black community, we ain't never had nothing just given to us. We had to go get it.
Yeah, we had to go
if
get it.
If it mean, you know, stealing, if it could mean killing or whatever, they just had to go get it.
True.
Like, some people just don't understand our reasoning behind doing things. I'm not saying doing, you know, anything bad or anything like that, but, you know, we were wired to do it, you know.
True.
You know, our ancestors, you know what I'm saying, they had to go get it by any means necessary. And you know, the slave master, you know, created our ancestors like that. They molded our ancestors like that, and it just been passed down from generation to generation. So
yeah,
it's just how it's just instilled in us, man.
Yeah.
I
think I definitely starts with pride, man. Even with, you know, from a biblical perspective, you know, from a spiritual perspective, the word already tells us that pride comes before the fall.
Yep.
And so us men, we got to figure out a way to, you know, be more vulnerable, be more open, and without being judged or criticized.
Real time.
In order to, you know, grow and be better. And so, yeah, man, I think that's one of the biggest keys, though, is pride. Yeah. What you got, man?
I'm finna get real, real deep. And it may, like I said, it may ruffle some feathers, but I had to learn this myself. I had to mirror check. You know what I'm saying?
Check
I really
your mirror.
Had to really do this, and this is something I learned. So, one of the things that men are afraid to admit to a woman is something simple, but yet so meaningful. We don't know how to love. We really don't. You know, being in a household with just a single mother, we didn't see our father loving our mother.
True.
We didn't see you know, we saw our grandparents and everything, you know what I'm saying? But that relationship between mother and father, we did not see. And then us being raised by society, you know what I'm saying? They telling us this is how a man's supposed to be.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? You know, the only time you protect a woman is if it's your mother, your grandmother, your aunt, your cousins, your sisters. Other than that, a woman is just a, you know, that word, you shouldn't have no type of respect for.
Right.
You the man, you in charge. whatever they taught us in society is basically is that woman has no value, you know what I'm saying, to you besides one or two things, you know, either sexual or, you know, sexual, creating family basically, and just feeding you or having a place to stay. That's it.
That's it, yeah.
So it didn't go anything further than that. So that's where we were never taught or ever saw love. Like, even in the streets, like, you say, oh, you hanging out with your OG and your little, your homeboys and all that stuff. And y'all might do some things. You might get in trouble or something like that. But love gonna truly, truly have your back.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Sometimes they ain't got your back. Do they really love you? You know what I'm saying? So that's a friendship love right there. But I'm speaking specifically talking about the relationship between men and women.
Mm-hmm.
Like, we never saw that. Only time we really saw it was on movies and television.
In television, yeah.
Like, period. Yeah. Like, we saw Family Matters. We saw Harriet and Carl. We saw Uncle Phil and Aunt Vivian. We saw all that. But we didn't see it in our own household.
True.
So one thing that we do is, what men like to do is, they like to lie to women. Like, instead of being straight up, hey, I don't know how to love you. I'm going to be straight up, which I don't know how to love you. So bear with me. I'm working. Let me learn how to love myself.
Yes, sir.
And let me, on this journey, you know what I'm saying? Me learning to love myself will only make me a better lover to give to you, a better, you know, I'll be able to give my heart to you then fully.
Right.
You know, but, you know, we just don't know how to admit it. And so we tell women lies all the time. Like, we just do.
Yeah.
It's just because, like I said, we don't know how to love. Like, we'll tell a woman, oh, I love you. No, we lust you. It's a whole completely different thing. No, we lust you.
Two different things.
Yeah, we lust you. And then it's like, we know all the words to make a woman feel good. Like,
yeah.
A man can lie in a minute, you know, and then just tell a woman and make her feel like she's the only woman in the world for him. Mm-hmm. And then, like, 5 minutes later, y'all cheating. You know what I'm saying?
True.
I mean, men, we were wired that way. It's just how we were made. Like, so a woman must understand, like, a man's background, his upbringing.
Yeah.
Once a woman truly understand that, then she can kind of decipher, okay, is he even worth pursuing? Or is this relationship even worth it?
That's
because
good.
Now you see the person's background, and you be like, oh, I see the people he hang around. I see the people he used to talk to. Nah. Yeah. I mean, it can save you from a lot of heartache if you just pay attention to detail.
Oh, that's
all
good.
You got to do. Just pay attention. And specifically, like, if a woman go on a date with a man knows what he wants from that woman as soon as he, in today's world, message that woman on social media. He know exactly what he wants. So if a woman asks him on a date, you don't even have to ask on a date, what are you looking for? The man, if you just listen, he gonna tell you. He gonna tell you, oh, you know, I just wanna find somebody I can kick it with, you know what I'm saying? If it do go somewhere further, it just happened. That's a waste of your time.
Yeah.
That's a waste of your time. I'm just being real. But back on topic. But men just don't know how to love, man. Like, in today's world, even growing up, man, men would prey on women, you know. And I'm not talking about prey. I'm talking about, you know, the P-R-E-Y.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
So that's a huge difference. If you actually love someone, you're going to pray, P-R-A-Y, for them. You're going to pray for their soul. You're going to keep them uplifted. You're going to be, you know, that pillar on that journey, you know, just try to keep them on that straight and narrow.
Right.
Other than that, man, like I said, you got these men out here preying on women. And I can understand why women think, you know, all men are dogs. But sometimes you just got to take a look at that person in the mirror and say, is it truly that man or is it really me? You know what I'm saying? What am I really attracted to? Maybe I am attracted to a number of dogs.
Mm-hmm.
You know, maybe I need to change my preferences. maybe my morals isn't correct.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So you got to really truly self-reflect. So I really truly believe that men are afraid to admit they don't know, they just don't know how to love.
They don't know how to love.
They know how to love society. They know how to love their OG. They know how to love, you know, the people they get in trouble with. They know how to love them. But when it comes to a woman, we just don't flat out know how to love.
That's good.
I mean, that's just me. That's how I look at it.
Ooh, putting love in the wrong places.
Man. Ooh, real talk.
That's deep, man. So was there ever some experiences that you've encountered or had, you know, when it comes to, you know, that's, I know you mentioned, you know, growing up in a single parent home and stuff like that. And so, you know, were there some experiences that you had to overcome in order to?
So I really said that because that I was one of those people, you know what I'm saying? Like in college, like I had a real girlfriend in high school. I had somebody I just talked on the phone with. And then like we did extracurricular activities, you know, outside of school. But you know, I had a girlfriend in college, like we literally spending like every single day with each other, bro. And I really sat down over the years and sat there and was like, you know, if I truly loved her, love heals.
Yeah.
Love actually leads, you know, to a better place. Love covers all wounds. Love does so much things.
Yeah, it does, man.
Love builds up. I only tearing her down. Mm. I was really lusting her, bro. Everything, like when I just really truly sat there, I was like, did I really love her? No. I was in lust with her.
Yeah, lusting.
Boy, every day we was you know. Every day, like
keep them 100.
I'm just being real, man. If she was on her monthly thing, we got other things, you know what I'm saying? So that's just me, like, during that time, just being real with y'all. But, man, I experienced that, man. Like, I truly had to learn and sit down and reflect and just say, man, I ain't love her. And I really want to go back and apologize to her just for my childish and selfish ways.
Right.
But you know, we don't even talk anymore. She married, so you know, God know my heart. So you know, what I'm saying, I was a child then, and I had to put my childish ways behind me and move forward and really just learn to truly love myself and love God and go down a better path and learn from my mistakes, man. That's one thing that men don't do. Like, they don't take the time to heal.
To heal, yeah.
They don't take the time to love themselves.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That. So we bring these past traumas into a new relationship. And then we always comparing, you know, the past with the current. And then that creates that drama. And then all of a sudden that drama's there. Then we go try to look outside the relationship to heal something, which we actually bring in more drama and more trauma until the current relationship. It's just all a domino effect. So
that's good.
That's all a part of not admitting that we don't know how to love a woman, even love ourselves.
Yeah.
That's a part of we don't know how to do.
Yeah.
So that's how I look at it, man. So you know what I mean?
Love your neighbor as yourself.
Man.
Love your neighbor as yourself. Now, you're right about that, man. It definitely starts with us as men, you know.
Right.
Looking at ourselves in the mirror and learning how to love ourselves first.
Right.
Because it'd be very difficult for us to be able to love women the way we should if we're not really loving ourselves the way we should and having that confidence in ourselves and working on ourselves and getting better.
Right.
You know, it's going to be very, very hard for us to, you know, love a woman like we should and let down our own guards. You know, take off the Superman cape and be Clark Kent sometimes,
right,
man.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Be vulnerable. So.
I know, like in previous episodes, like I said, you know, I truly learned how to love someone because I saw that woman as somebody's mother, future mother, somebody's sister, somebody's daughter.
Yeah.
So I put that woman in my mom's shoes, I put that woman in my sister's shoes, and I saw a reflection of that woman.
That's good.
You know what I'm saying? So that made me say, okay, when I want somebody to treat my sister the way I treat that woman, if a man just sat there and really did that, just say, hey, do I want another man to treat my mama the way I treat this woman. If they really did that and just really said that, they're like, nah, I don't want that. So why are we doing it?
Why?
I mean, I
hope y'all listening, man. That was a gem right there, man. That's powerful, bro.
Man, yeah. You just gotta sit there and just self-reflect and just be like, sometimes and it's just not all about you. You know what I'm saying? You gotta see it from other people's perspective.
True.
And that's the way life is. You just can't just focus all in on yourself. You gotta take the whole picture in.
Yeah.
That's the only way you get a better view. That's the only way your point of view will change.
Yeah, exactly. If you see better, you do better.
Man.
If you see better, you do better, man. That's a powerful nugget, man. If we actually took the time, you know, based on the relationships that we're in, you know, would we actually treat that woman, you know, the way they need to be treated, you know, as far as our sisters and mothers and aunties, you know, women figures that are in our lives, will we do them, you know, the same way? And so, yeah.
Man, I wish a girl would make my mama, my sister, my aunt, my grandma, anybody cry. I wish they would.
Yeah.
Because trust me, they going to see me every day. Every day. They might whoop me a few times, but they going to have hell all of them. You know, I ain't to act like I'm the toughest dude in the world, but you know, I ain't scared of no whooping, you know what I'm saying? Everybody lose.
Oh yeah.
He gonna have to catch me on a bad day and I don't have too many rows. Just saying.
You win some, you lose some.
But you live to fight another day.
Fight another
day. You know. That's true. That's 100% facts though, but so yeah, y'all just put yourself in. Just switch places. I remember on, what's that? It was a TV show, like, they swapped places. It was like the man and the woman swapped places. The man became the woman, the woman became the man. And I think about the Cosbys or something. I don't know. But Bill Cosby on the episode, he was pregnant on one of the episodes. So he basically took on something that the woman had. So he put himself in a woman and he finally understood, okay, this is why a woman does this. This is why a woman, sometimes we gotta just picture ourselves in that woman's shoes and that, you know, and just say, hey, when I want somebody to treat me this way.
Yeah.
I mean, we gotta do that sometime, man. Like, Why do we do what we do? I know society plays a role. You know, growing up in a single parent family home, but why are we continue to allow this cycle to continue? Like,
yeah.
Why can't we break it? Why can't we be the example of how a relationship should be?
Should look
like.
You know
what I'm saying? Like, why can't we be that? You know, we always look to social media or something. Oh, they got the perfect relationship. We don't know what storm or what trouble they may be going through at home.
Yeah.
I mean.
True.
They may hate each other. They may hate each other guts. But in public, like Bill and Hillary Clinton. Let me stop with their business now. But we know, if you really truly know Bill and Hillary, they are married, but only in public. But they don't even live in the same city. They don't live in the same house. She just keeps the Clinton name because that's what about really, about our fame, really.
Right.
But they're not together. They haven't been together since, what, 93, 94, 95, ooh, somewhere around there?
Man, I was a baby.
So, yeah, they ain't been together. So, everything that looks good on the outside might not be good on the inside.
True.
It can be your house, too. You know, you might have a beautiful, beautiful house on the outside, but your home is hell on the inside.
Man.
And it can be just in the same way, physically and spiritually. Like, you can be the most beautiful person on the outside, but your soul can just be like, you can have a hateful spirit. You can have a spirit that's just so dark and full of evil or just like so
true.
Negative.
True.
You know what
true.
I'm saying? Like, you just got to look at the inside and say, man, look, I got to just reflect on this and try to improve and become better. Start breaking these cycles and
true.
Learning how to love myself and learn how to lead, learn how to provide. Learn how to truly protect, learn how to, you know, cover, learn how to pray, learn how to just do it all, man. Like, just take the time and to step back and just really, truly, truly, truly love yourself. Truly. Got anything to add on that, man? Come on.
Come on. Roll. Oh, yeah. I think another one.
Roll on.
Hey, everybody, get your roll. Hey, shout out Big Tom.
Real time.
I think there's another fear, man, that men struggle with or wrestle with is the fear of being overwhelmed and afraid to show it, being overwhelmed. Because you got to think about it, yes. Bro. As men, like I said earlier, we're taught to provide, we're taught to do this, we're taught to do that. Mm-hmm. At the end of the day, life is going to happen.
Yes.
Life is going to happen. Life is going to put us on roller coasters. We're going to have highs. Right. We're going to have lows. We're going to go through valley experiences. We're going to be on a mountaintop sometimes.
That's a fact.
We're going to go through mixed emotions. All these different things going on. And so I think a lot of times, us as men, you know, trying to bottle that stuff in, and not really getting the help that we need and showing up in the house like everything's cool when it really isn't. So I think that's another fear that men struggle with is the ability to not share with their significant other or their wife or their girlfriend. If they're overwhelmed, like, you know, I need your help.
Yeah.
You know, I need your help. You know, I got a lot going on. I'm trying to figure it out for the both of us, for the betterment of our relationship, for our household, for our family, for our careers or whatever it is. And so, like I was saying, in the beginning, us being wired, you know, and taught and trained, you know, to provide and go get all these different things. At the end of the day, what that's doing is that's physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually draining you.
Correct.
You know, as a man. And so I think that's another huge fear that us men, you know, wrestle with and afraid to share with our women.
Right.
You know, because they're always looking for us to do this and do that. And so, you know, like you're saying, you know, changing the lens and allowing the women to see it from my side, you know, I can come in and help you lighten that load, you know, whatever you need, babe. You know, if you need me to do this, you need me to do that, let's sit down together and find a better way to strategize and work this out, you know.
Right.
I think that's another huge one, man, is us bottling that in, you know, feeling overwhelmed and not being able to open up and share that.
Right. So that stems down to that pride.
Yeah.
Being selfish, to be honest.
Yeah.
You know, when women say, oh, men are selfish, I agree. Not all, but I would say 95% of men are selfish just because how, like I said, we were raised.
Yeah.
And on behalf of the good men out there, I do apologize about that, man. Like, I just apologize for, you know, your experience. Hold on to hope. There are good men out here.
Oh yeah, that's something out there, woman.
I just wanted to bring that to y'all attention. And,
yeah,
you know, I think another thing a man fear to admit is, we just don't know how to lead. I believe a lot of men just don't know how to lead.
That's a good one too.
Our whole life we've been followers. Like, we followed the OGs. We follow somebody. We never saw a true leader around.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? We always follow. So when a woman say, "Oh, I want somebody who can lead," we like, we get hesitant. I think this is how you lead it, and we leading down the wrong path.
Yeah.
We're leading around the wrong path, man. And then, you know, she get tied up in our drama and our past and all that stuff, and we just destroyed another woman and who truly don't believe that. Oh, there's good men out there. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So I believe that we fear that we just don't know how to admit that we just don't straight out know how to lead.
Why?
Like. So, I mean, I understand in order to be a leader, you must follow.
Right.
You must understand the characteristics of what a leader truly has.
Right.
And once you learn those characteristics, then you start positioning yourself and start surrounding yourself with people who is going to, they're leaders in their own way, but they're going to push you to get to where you need to go, and you gotta all get there together.
Right.
But they're gonna come to you and say, "Hey, you know, you become wise when you're a true leader. You get wisdom."
Yeah. Facts.
So people will come to you and ask you, or just follow you just based on, you know, just the light that you have, the wisdom that you gained. You know what I'm saying? So that's one thing that I think another man lacked is wisdom. You know what I'm saying? What are we around to gain it?
Yeah.
Why we don't even position ourselves to gain wisdom?
It's good.
If it ain't about the streets or playing basketball, football, running track, boxing, whatever, it's just like everything don't matter.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's good. I can definitely attest when it comes to wisdom. You know, I've been reading a lot or listening to a lot of you know, messages on King Solomon.
Yeah, you know,
and I think it's in Second Kings. It's in Second Kings when it talked about of how he prayed a specific prayer, and he asked God. He didn't ask God for possessions. He didn't ask God for monetary value. He didn't ask God for all this wealth and riches. The one thing that he asked for was wisdom. The one thing that he prayed and asked God for was wisdom, discernment, and understanding.
Yes.
And because he prayed those things, God heard his prayer. And not only did God answer his prayer, but God gave him possessions and honor without him even asking for it.
Yep, yep.
And so, yeah, like you were saying, bro, that's one thing we got to learn, too, as men, is how to, you know, not only have understanding, but wisdom.
Right.
At the same time, and knowing, you know, how to manage it. Because understanding is the know-how, but you got to have wisdom in order to know, you know, to do it the right way.
Real talk.
And so, yeah, wisdom is definitely key.
Yeah. What else you thinking? We go out, man.
Yeah, this is a broad one, man. This is a good one. What else can we hit on, man? What's going on in your head? What else you got, man?
I'm gonna really ruffle some feathers, and women gonna be like, "Ooh, yes, Lord." Men are afraid to admit that we just don't know how to be honest. We don't. Like, we, you know, men, like I say, in the street, they don't lie their way to all that money. You know what I'm saying? Whatever you do in the street, I ain't gonna put nobody business out there. You done lied your way to get all that money.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You done did some mischievous things to get that money. You know what I'm saying? And when somebody asks you, man, how you get it? You know, we beat around the bush instead of telling, hey, this is how you get it. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, we just can't be honest with ourselves. We don't know how to be honest with ourselves. Therefore, it reflects that we can't be honest with anybody else, like specifically women. Like I said, we'll lie to a woman to basically tell them, you know, what they want to hear, just so they can leave us alone or give us whatever they want.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? We were molded to, I'm gonna ruffle some feathers saying this, to manipulate. if you ever hear a man, like, they always try to manipulate the system, like they try to manipulate the system, they try to find ways and make quick money. They try to manipulate all this. They manipulate women to get what they want. So this is how a lot of men were brought up, is like how to manipulate to get something out of something, you know, get the return of something out of something, only to benefit themselves, and they don't care about anybody else. That's why you got kids stealing from their parents.
That's good.
That's why you got kids murdering their parents. You know what I'm saying? Because they trying to get something out of their parents, or just like a man, they're trying to get something out of that woman, and then once they get it, they have nothing else to do with it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Becomes damaged goods then.
Yeah. I was on this, I sent it to you on Instagram. This guy was saying a man never really receives a fullness or the goodness of a woman in her prime. And I agree with this 100%, because a lot of women, they have preferences. Like, they have this man, like, okay, he got to be 6'8".
Uh-huh.
He got to be a certain build. He got to be hooper. He got to be football. He got to be this. He got to have 1,000,001 tattoos. But then everything that they built this imaginary man, and they think they got that man, and they only see the outside of him. They don't understand what this man be battling internally. So he might bring you through hell or something like that. He done got you pregnant. He done got you 3 or 4 babies. And all of a sudden, you like, okay, I done been through 3 men. I got 3 babies, and they all 3 different baby daddies or whatnot. And then all of a sudden, you trying to find that good man. And now you coming out with this baggage from this old relationship. You got these kids and all this other stuff. So he like, you know, it's gonna be hard for you to actually trust me now because of your past trauma. So he was basically saying, like, we never get the best of their prom because they've been hurt. They done had kids. We never get the best of a woman in their prime. Like, it's like when they go through a whole bunch of stuff, then they're ready to settle down. Then they're ready to give us pieces of themselves to us. They can never give them the fullness. I can agree to it to a certain extent.
Yeah.
But also, you know, life is about trial and error. We go through things, we learn through things, you know. It's right. The same thing with men. Men, we never give the fullness of ourselves to women. We go through stuff, we love the streets. Bros before, you know, the 304, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's us, you know what I'm saying? It's like, we never really give the fullness of a woman because we done slept around with 1,000,001 women. We done lied to 1,000,001 women. May have kids with, you know, women. And all of a sudden, and then it's like, you know what? I'm getting old, man. I'm lonely now. I have nobody. Now, all of a sudden, now we're looking for that woman.
That woman, yeah. Yeah. Then when you finally get to that woman, you know, and try to share, you know, the things that you went through or you were exposed to in your past trauma and past failures, and everything takes a turn.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, it takes a turn. And them skeletons come out the closet.
Man, real talk.
Yeah, wow, that's definitely a way to look at. It's definitely a way to look at it, man.
I'm just roughing the feathers, y'all. You know, I ain't trying to give too much information out. You know what I'm saying? But is there something that this conversation that needs to be had? That uncomfortable conversation, like,
yeah.
I want y'all to just take what we're saying, and men and women, just like sit down with, you know, your partner, you know, your spouse. Sit down with them, just talk, and just say, hey, look. You know, I understand that you struggle to, you know, truly love. I understand that. What can I do to help that? You know, like if a man open up to a woman, don't use what he tell you against him, you know, at a moment of when he, like, at a moment is like when he's going through hell. It's like, if he telling you, you know, I just lost my job, man. I can't provide for my family. And then all of a sudden, you get mad at him. Oh, you ain't nothing but a B word.
Yeah,
man.
Yeah.
You can't even keep a job. You can't even pay these bills. You know how that tears a man down.
Yeah, that breaks
build
me.
That king up. Build that. You're that woman. You're supposed to be his. You're supposed to be his rib. You know what a rib does? A rib support and keeps a man up straight.
Yes,
so once you break that rib, you're gonna be up pain. You're gonna be leaning and say you can't. You can't walk straight and narrow. You're going to walk at an angle once you break that rib.
Yes,
so
sir.
You got to support that man. That woman's supposed to be that rib to keep that man up straight. It's like the man is the head, but the woman is the neck. So the woman determines the direction the man goes. You know what I'm saying? Ooh. So that the neck holds the head up.
Thanks.
So if there's no strong neck, then the head just like my head. You know what I'm saying? My head, you know, big head.
No sense of guidance. So, no sense of direction. All, none of that.
So,
man.
Women, wow. We need you.
Yeah.
We need you. Like, we all go through things, but we need you. And we do apologize for all the trials and tribulations and all the trauma and everything that we just put y'all through. We do apologize about that. But like I said, there are good men out here who are ready to lead, who are ready to mentor other men, who are willing to connect with other men and just trying to bring out the best of them. And crazy thing is, MirrorCheck is actually going to start something where we gather not just men, but we're going to focus specifically on men at certain times where we just all get together and we just fellowship. We can be Bible study, we can do shooting some pool, basketball, whatever.
Right.
You know, just group of men getting together, then, you know, eventually we'll just, you know, bring in women. We just have all these different functions, you know what I'm saying? But, yeah, we're just trying to build each other up and just bring out the best and learn how to love our women. You know what I'm saying? That's where we fail, man. Like, we just got to break those cycles.
Yeah.
We've been carrying that torch too long. It's time to sit that down and light up another torch and show a different path. Because,
man,
I'm tired of it. To be honest.
Yeah, I am too, man. I'm definitely tired of seeing unhealthy relationships and toxicity and things not, you know, looking the way they should look, you know, concerning black love and stuff like that. And so, and I'm grateful, man, to even, you know, continue, you know, in my journey, you know,
right.
I always quote it. Y'all heard me say it throughout our podcast journey, man.
Right.
Going on 10 years of marriage, man. And, you know, allowing myself to be open and more vulnerable and, you know, vice versa. And,
allowing
my wife, you know, to come in and, you know, play her role like you were saying. You know, the woman is the rib. So she helps support, you know, support that man. You don't,
right.
You know, if you think you know, about your own self, about your own, you know, human natural body, if they're real broken, man,
it's hard to breathe.
It's hard to breathe. You out of there, man. You're in pain.
Real talk.
Yeah, you can't walk straight. You just discombobulated. And so, Can't sleep right. Yeah, that analogy of that woman being our help, being our real, man, it's the supporters. Right. And so, you know, women, I just, you know, would advise, when you see your man going through, when you see a man trying to get back on his feet, you know, trying to bounce back, don't use his vulnerability as a crutch.
Real talk.
Don't use his vulnerability against him, man. Allow him to open up, allow him to share what he has to share, and build him up, man, so that you guys can grow together. Because I'm pretty sure he would probably do the same for you, had, you know, if you were to open up and share with him about some things that you're going through. And so, yeah, man, it's here to, just here to build relationships. Yeah, I've been preaching this, and I'm going to keep preaching, man. Just keep building each other up, man. That's what I want to see.
You know, the crazy thing is when you said something about a dysfunctional, basically, of black house like relationships. Think about this. When we were growing up, what we saw on TV, we saw like, okay, this black family, they had their issues and stuff like that, but they always were solid.
Always.
They always came back together. They always loved. You look on TV now, how Hollywood has it now, black families are so dysfunctional. Look at the, if you used to watch Empire, I started watching it after like the first couple episodes.
Yeah,
but you had Lucius, you know, and Cookie and all this other stuff. And then you had they children, like one of his sons was messing with his girlfriend and all this other stuff. It was just so dysfunctional. And you look at every episode of a black family, everything is dysfunctional.
Yeah.
You don't tell you why, it's because it creates viewers. That's what people like to laugh at. As a, you don't see any dysfunctional white people, like white families on TV. To be honest, you don't see any dysfunctional Hispanic families on TV, except for George Lopez. But you didn't see any of that, bro. Like,
yeah.
So we became the butt of the joke now. Like, we gotta break that.
Yeah, we gotta break that.
And one reason why I do not like Kevin Hart now is years ago, like this was 2011, and I called him out on it. He was basically saying nobody likes dark skinned women because they have bad credit, or he was just basically just thrashing them and basically saying, oh, I'll never date a dark skinned, you know, woman or whatnot. And you know, he a comedian, so I mean, he was serious at that point. But then you saying that's coming out your mouth, that's letting, like, that's going around the world. Everybody paying attention to that.
Yeah.
So everybody saying, oh, I can't date this dark skinned woman because she ain't got no hair, or she got bad credit, or whatever. Come on now. We got to be careful what we putting out. Whatever comes out of our mouth, we got to be careful. Ooh. Because people are paying attention to what we say. Not only what we do, but what we say too. So
life and death is in the power of the tongue.
That's a fact. And so we gotta be careful about that, man. Like, it all appears now, like we gotta learn to love ourselves. And then once we learn to love ourselves, we can love others the way we would actually want somebody else to love us.
True.
So it just all appears back to looking in the mirror. Checking that mirror.
Checking that mirror, man.
Y'all like that title, huh? Mirror check.
Checking that mirror.
We always gonna tie something back to always checking that mirror, man. Because that's very important. Because nobody can change something until you change yourself.
Yes, sir.
Like they always say, be the change you want to see. Yeah, you got to change. You got to look in the mirror and change yourself, and then go out there and try to change the world.
Yes, sir.
You ain't going to get everybody at once, but it just takes one person to take that step, because somebody else going to, you know, take the torch and say, y'all saw this person. Look at Gandhi, and then he inspired Martin Luther King. You know what I'm saying? I ain't more so on the Martin Luther King. I'm on the Malcolm X side, but he changed the world.
Yeah.
So it just all starts with that reflection, that self self-accountability, just looking at that person in the mirror, just start hold yourself accountable, and then surround yourself with people who's going to hold you accountable, and you know, surround yourself with leaders, and just go out there and try to change one life at a time.
Big facts.
Or change, or have better interactions with people, have better interactions with women, just start being honest with women, be honest with yourself first. I mean, because I know a lot of times, you know, we just dishonest with self. And that leads to being dishonest with others.
Others, exactly.
So, yeah. what else you thinking, man?
Ooh, I think we didn't drop some gems. I think we didn't ruffle some feathers, man. But like you're saying, these conversations are needed, man. These topics are needed, man, when it comes to having, you know, healthy relationships, in the African-American community, man. What we want to see instead of what we're seeing being portrayed on social media.
Right, and TV
shows and drama field and stuff like that. No, that's not all black families, man.
Yeah, we ain't Lucius and Cookie.
You know what I'm saying? Take it back to Family Matters. Take it back to Parenthood. You know what I'm saying? Those type of shows.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, man.
Uncle Phil. Fresh Prince.
Fresh Prince.
You gotta mention that too. You gotta take it back.
You
gotta take it back to good times. Even though they was always Florida was always mad at James, you know, but they was always a family.
Always a family.
Man, so, yeah, you gotta take it back and just really reflect, man. And just, like I said, just learn to love yourself and heal yourself and truly understand yourself and gain that wisdom. And it's going to, pass down to others. Once you learn to love and reflect and heal and gain wisdom and you attach yourself to somebody else, they're gonna become a reflection of you, and then they're gonna be able to pass it down to somebody. Somebody's gonna become a reflection of them. Mm-hmm. So it just takes just one person, you know, to change the cycle, man. We gotta break the cycle. And just start admitting, you know, the truth. And just start speaking the truth. Instead of hiding stuff, you know, stop being so prideful. You know, everything stems from being selfish. I don't care what it is. All sin is a form of selfishness, if you really look at it.
Yeah, selfishness.
Everything stems from being selfish.
Mm-hmm. Self-centered.
So, yeah, man. So, we got to just take that look in the mirror, man. I'm going to keep on saying that. Take that look in the mirror because it's very important.
Shake it out.
And we got to change. Start loving. Start loving everybody. Start loving these women like you love your mother and your sister.
Big facts.
Your cousin, your aunt, your grandma. Yeah, I know you love your grandma.
Oh, yeah.
So you got to
transfer that same love, man, that you show to your grandparents, man. I promise you, yeah.
I already know some dude, but they ain't my family. They ain't my blood. But still. Put your sister in that woman's shoes. Mm-hmm. Put your mother in that woman's shoes.
Right.
And I guarantee your whole outlook will change on women, how you treat them, how you talk to them, how you lead them, how you love them. It all change. But it all starts with you. Just remember that. I don't know what I was looking at when I was pointing, but yeah. I don't know. I was in a trance. Like, I was just like,
yeah, I saw you. Yeah, he's like,
I didn't even blink.
Yeah, he's locked in. Yeah.
So yeah, because I truly really mean this, man. Like, real talk.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. So we'll go ahead and wrap this up, man. Go ahead and talk to the people. Let them know what's up.
Man, I just appreciate you guys, man. Continuing to follow this, you know, MirrorCheck brand and sticking with us, and you know, commenting and sharing our posts and, you know, feedback, and just continuing to rock with it, man, on this MirrorCheck journey. You know, it's the reason why we picked this specific name for this brand, because at the end of the day, MirrorCheck is a daily thing. It's a daily thing, man. It's a journey. It's not a destination. So it's a daily thing for us to check our mirror each and every day we wake up, you know, and God gives us the activity of our limbs,
right,
to have that ability to go look in our mirror and fix those things that needs to be fixed, man. So we really appreciate you guys for continuing just rocking with us, man, you know, and moving forward in this journey. But we got more in store, man.
Yeah, for sure.
We got more in store.
Yeah, man. And y'all just do us a favor. Go follow us on our Instagram, which is MirrorCheckPodcast. Also, we got another Instagram, MirrorCheck.Clothing. We will be having some things released shortly. Go follow us on Twitter, MirrorCheck_, TikTok, MirrorCheck_, Facebook, MirrorCheck Podcast. Just remember, we're more than a podcast, though. So, yeah, go follow us on there. Comment, give us something that we should talk about. Or we'll also let y'all know when we get ready to live stream. And so we'll be able to interact with our fans. That's one thing that we want to do. We want to interact with you guys. We want to start putting names and faces and shaking hands and being, you know, out in the public. speaking of being out in the public, we are going to host our first event next month. More details will be offered on our social media platform. So like I said, just go follow us, and more details will be offered about our first social event. And also go to our website, www.checkyourmirror.com, where you'll be able to go register, subscribe, and you'll be receiving like newsletters, special promotional offers. You'll get, first dibs on exclusive products. We'll take care of you. Trust me, we'll take care of you, because, you know, you didn't have to go subscribe. You didn't have to support, but you did, and we make sure we'll take care of you. We have big things and planned within the next few months. Just go follow us on our social media platforms and our website for those updates. We got great things coming out, man. Like, seriously, like, if you're real talented, just know we got something big coming up. What else? Man, y'all, just stay safe. You know, stay blessed, stay covered. Love yourself, love each other. And you know what? We know you can't leave y'all guys with this. If it's always someone else's fault, I'm pretty sure y'all got mirrors around the house, in the bathroom, somewhere.
Somewhere.
Go in there and just look at yourself in the mirror. Don't be like, ooh, I'm fine. Now, truly, truly look at yourself.
Thanks.
Just look at yourself and just like, why is it always, it's always somebody, this is why it's like going this way. It's always somebody else's fault. No. You point that finger, no. It all comes back to you. That finger is connected to a hand, which that hand is connected to a wrist. That wrist is connected to an arm. Guess what that arm is connected to? A body. And guess what that body is? That's you. So it all comes back to you.
Mm-hmm.
So if you point that finger, I always point that finger at somebody else, that means your mirror dirty. So you got to clean that mirror. Start shining up. Start accepting your flaws. And turn those flaws into greatness. Anything you got to say?
That's all I got. Peace.
All right, there you go. All right, man. Y'all be blessed.